Good evening and welcome to Current Affairs. Today I would like to talk to you with respect to 38th floor. What exactly is this? You might have heard so many times, and I was using this particular name of an institution so many number of times during our discussions. That is nothing but United Nations. And the majority of the offices of the United Nations, they are located in New York. Similarly, if you talk about General Assembly of United Nations, Security Council, for that matter, Secretariat, so all these offices are located in New York. And in that particular building, the 38th floor has been allocated to the United Nations Secretariat. So regarding that, I would like to talk to you now. And that Secretariat is headed by Secretary General. So this is the designation that has been given, and it is headed by Secretary General, considered to be one of the very, very powerful and important positions as far as the entire United Nations is concerned. And once a person is occupying this particular position, he will continue for a period of 5 years. And again, he may be elected, again he can continue for another term. Meaning, the United Nations Charter talks about the term of the Secretary General of Secretariat, and the term is 5 years. Right? So now, why we are talking about this? So the present Secretary General is Ban Ki-moon. Ban Ki-moon, and this gentleman's term is going to come to an end by the end of this particular year. So from January 1st, 2017, so you need to pick up a new person. So considered to be very, very responsible position. That's the reason why last year itself, in the year 2015 only, the President of the General Assembly and the President of the Security Council, so they have asked for the nominations. What do you mean by this? So now you need to pick up a person, and the person has to be appointed as the Secretary General. How do you do this? Now, what exactly happens is that the Secretary General is appointed by the General Assembly. What do you mean by General Assembly? General Assembly is nothing but a group of members. Today in United Nations, we have 193 countries. All 193 countries put together are the members in the General Assembly. And that General Assembly will appoint the Secretary General of Secretariat, but on the recommendation of the United Nations Security Council. So this is a very, very powerful body. When I was talking about the United Nations, I explained you all these points. Few points let me touch now. In United Nations Security Council, the strength is 15, 15. Out of that, 5 are permanent members and the remaining 10 are non-permanent members. So permanent members will be there forever. And when it comes to the non-permanent member, the term of each member will be 2 years. So this is how it will happen. But as we all know that these permanent 5 will exercise veto powers. Meaning, in order to take a decision in the Security Council, all the permanent 5 members must accept. If 4 countries will say yes and 1 country will say no, the answer will be no. That is the reason why, so this is a powerful body, and this Security Council will recommend a name to the General Assembly, and that is accepted by General Assembly, and the General Assembly will be appointing the same person as the Secretary General, and he will continue for a period of 5 years. This is how the present gentleman, Ban Ki-moon, so he was the Secretary General for Secretariat for 2 terms. So first term he became the Secretary General on January 1st, 2007. And he will continue up to December 31st, 2016, meaning this year end. So before that one, you need to pick up someone. So that is the reason why the nomination process has been started. So many countries, so many groups will be giving the nominations. But this time, why it is so important is that for the first time in the history of the United Nations, there is a serious talk that let a woman be the Secretary General. Never in the history of United Nations so far, there was no woman Secretary General. For the first time, it's a seriously talked issue. And of course, I'll give you some names also. These are the four runners, the women are the four runners as far as becoming the Secretary General is concerned. Am I clear? So that's the point number one. But how do you pick up, first of all? How do you pick up? So any candidate, see, generally what will happen, we look at our MLA. We look at our Member of Parliament. So they speak something. So maybe MLA may be controlling few people. Member of Parliament may be controlling few people. Minister is controlling more people. Chief Minister is controlling more people. Prime Minister controls more people. That's the reason why, in order to become the Prime Minister of a nation, it is not everybody's job. I told you already, lots of responsibilities are there on the shoulders of the person who is holding the responsibility. So that is the reason why they have to be very careful and they need to work extra. So they have to exhibit their leadership qualities and they should prove themselves as the leaders. That is the reason why everybody cannot become the Chief Minister or the Prime Minister, and very few people have those qualities. So within a state and within a country, this is the problem. You want somebody to head an international organization. You want someone to become the head of the international organization, that too in the United Nations, where 193 countries are the members. Then obviously, it is not an easy task, not at all an easy task. So the person who is holding those responsibilities must be a person with lots of calibers. That's the reason why a candidate is expected to have proven leadership qualities, managerial abilities, extensive experience in the international relations, and strong diplomatic skills, strong communication skills, and strong multilingual skills. So these are the qualities that are expected for a person so to be the Secretary General in the United Nations. So the nominations have been called up. Of course, this time there is a huge talk that a woman has to become the Secretary General. But so many male members are also coming into picture. Ultimately, that all depends on the caliber. And ultimately, above all, the name has to be finalized by the so-called Security Council. Until and unless these five members are not accepting, then it will not become a reality. That's the reason why sometime back, there is a group called Elders. Elders group. I'll tell you what is this. In fact, the group called Elders that was proposed by Nelson Mandela. With respect to Nelson Mandela, there is no necessity of any introduction because you all know I'm just living it. And they have given some proposal that Security Council, instead of sending just one name to General Assembly, you please send three names. You please send three names, and out of these three, one will be picked up by the General Assembly. Fantastic proposal, but not accepted by the permanent five. Not accepted by permanent five. Another proposal that is given by elders is that, I told you, the term of the Secretary General is 5 years. Again, he can continue for another 5 years. Is that okay? So like this, there is no limitation as far as number of terms are concerned. But the elders group, they have proposed that instead of giving another chance with an extension for another 5 years, let the term of this person, this office, be extended to 7 years. From five, let it become seven, and without any extension for that. But unfortunately, these proposals were not accepted by Security Council. That's the reason why. So just remaining like this. But kindly remember, Even in the previous classes also, I was talking about the reforms in the United Nations. It is a must. It is the need of the hour. Otherwise, on the name of the permanent five, you must know these names, no? I was telling you very frequently. United States of America, UK, France, Russia, and China. So these are the five nations which are considered to be P5. And until and unless this group is not accepting, nothing is going to become a reality. So when you have so many members in the world, in United Nations, 193, why there should be a domination of only few countries, only five countries? How come the five countries will be controlling the remaining entire world? The reasons are plenty. Now the questions are being asked that, so that it should not continue. There is a necessity of the reforms. That's the reason why some countries like India very, very seriously demanding that they also want to become the permanent member as far as the Security Council is concerned. Right? But when it happens, how it is going to happen, we have to wait and watch. Because so many factors will come into picture. Right? Japan is another country. It wants to become a permanent member. Brazil is another country. It wants to become a permanent member. South Africa is also there. So many countries are there, but we have to wait and watch what is going to happen. But otherwise, there is a necessity of the reforms in the United Nations. Because of any reason, if there is a split, there is no doubt that these five nations are very powerful. But because of any reason, if there is a split in the United Nations, and that will be very critical as far as the existence and survival of the United Nations itself. After all, it is an organization. Members have come together. They formed into a group. If there is a very serious division, obviously the organization will collapse. But it will be very good for the entire world to see that the organization should continue with certain modifications. There should not be any hegemony. No, the hegemony should not be continued only by the so-called the five nations. Right? That is the reason why the elders have proposed this, but it was not accepted by the so-called the Security Council. Am I clear? So we need to wait and watch. There is a possibility that a woman member may be elected as the so-called the Secretary General. This will happen for the first time. We need to wait. And of course, one more criticism is that so far, no Muslim person, no Hindu person, and no woman member became the Secretary Generals. But it's a very, very good position, commanding position. So you can initiate certain things. You can see that certain things happen in a positive direction in the world. Fine. Now, so what I'll do is that, so I'll open the document for you. So now I want you to please have a very, very close look towards this. The United Nations Secretary General term is coming to an end this year. The current Secretary General is Ban Ki-moon. He is in the office since January 1st, 2007, and the term is 5 years. Again, he was elected. That is the reason why the present term is the second term for this gentleman. So look at this. In December 2015, the President of General Assembly and the President of United Nations Security Council wrote a letter and called for nominations. Because the term is coming to an end, you need to pick up another person, right? That is the reason why they asked for nominations. Member states have been encouraged to present women members along with the men members. But what is important is that the candidates must have proven leadership, managerial abilities, extensive experience in international relations, strong diplomatic communication, and multilingual skills. Right? Now, so you need to remember, now look at this. How the Secretary General is chosen? he or she, right, it may be she this time, is appointed by the General Assembly on the recommendation of the Security Council. Appointed by United Nations General Assembly on the recommendation of United Nations Security Council. Is that okay? So we have to wait what is going to happen. Just now I told you, elders and their proposals. So what do you mean by elders, first of all? This is a group of international statesmen formed by Nelson Mandela. And this group includes the former President of United States of America, Jimmy Carter, and former United Nations Secretary General, Kofi Annan, and South African Archbishop Emeritus Desmond Tutu. So all these people so formed into a group, and that group was called elders. What are the proposals? Instead of one name, three names must be submitted to the General Assembly. What will happen now? Generally, if Security Council picking up one name, and that one name will be forwarded to General Assembly. There is no option. You have to appoint only that person. In Security Council, who is playing dominating role? P5. That's the reason why this is the hegemony of the P5. Hence, they have suggested that instead of one name, you send three names. Out of these three, one will be picked up by General Assembly, but it was not accepted by the so-called Security Council. Look at this. The term of the General Secretary, Secretary General, should be increased to 7 years. Now it is 5. From 5, it should be increased to 7 years. Instead of extending the term, it is better. And the current one should not be eligible for re-election. From 5, let it be 7. And the present person should not permit him to go for the re-election again. Otherwise, there are so many countries in the world. You need to give opportunity to various countries. So many talented people are there. People with the capability, ability. So you need to allow them. Right. But what happened? Ultimately, it was not accepted by the P5. Is it okay? And I'm going for the so-called, I have certain questions now. I'll show it to you. But before that one, I would like to just remind one thing. Our second batch for IAS 2017 is going to be launched from June 27th. I gave you the seminar. I told you the dates. June 23rd is the last date for registration. And let me make it very, very clear. After June 23rd, it will not be possible for you to get registered. Another batch may start in the month of November or December. So you may join there. But it is always advisable to join early so that you can prepare for the examination well in advance. I told you already, next June, June 18th, 2017 is your preliminary examination. That's the reason why I request the serious candidates to take the decision very, very, very quickly. Already the admissions are going on in a full swing. And if any serious candidate is there, please get registered and become a member and start learning, start enjoying all the subjects so that within a short period of time, you will become comfortable. Is that okay? And whatever the promises I have made during the seminar, every promise will be fulfilled. Every promise will be fulfilled. Instead of August, the examination is there in the month of June. But even then, every care will be taken, right? If it is reduced by 2 months also does not make any difference for us. So because our commitment levels are such, so we are going in such a fashion that every serious candidate who is there with us will be comfortable in learning, comfortable in understanding, comfortable in analyzing, comfortable in presentation. So this is how I am going to take every care like this. Is that okay? And I have committed myself so to give my best to you all. And I want you to commit to yourself so to perform better. Okay, at this stage, I can recollect one dialogue. Right, Salman Khan this time. Agar humne ek bar commitment kar di, fir apne aap ka bhi nahi sunta. So in the same manner, so we have committed whatever we have promised that we are going to do it. right? So very, very qualitatively you are going to do it. That's the reason why the decision is there in your hands. Take very, very early decision. Okay, it should not be too late, because after June 23rd, again I'm repeating, after June 23rd, the admissions will be completely, completely closed. Okay, and you need to join only the November or December batch. Now let me come back to you. Now look at this. I have a few questions with me. Have a look at this. Present strength of General Assembly. It's a general question. You must be knowing. Answer is C. That is 193. Kindly remember. Okay. Now I have one more question. Please have a look at this. You have 1, 2, 3, 4 statements, and you need to pick up the correct statements. Read one after the other. I told you how to read the questions. You have to read the question very clearly and thoroughly. Don't jump to the options. You have to read the statements first. This is how you need to read. If you look at ABCD, it will not give you answer. Rather, it will waste your time. That's the reason why first look at the question. What is the question? Which of the following statements is or correct? So if you can look down, 4 statements are there. You have to read, and you need to find out what are the statements that are correct. Because of the less time you will have in the examination, you have to read very, very, very thoroughly and very with lots of concentration. Read this. United States of America, UK, France, China, and Russia are the permanent members of the Security Council. Is it right or wrong? Obviously right. Just now I told you. Fine. The Secretary General is appointed by the General Assembly on the recommendation of the Security Council. That is also right. Just now we have discussed. Number 3, Yu Thant was the first Secretary General of United Nations. Did I ever tell you this point during our discussion on United Nations? Yes, you know, Yu Thant. He was the first Secretary General of UN, there is no doubt. But he was the first Secretary General of UN from Asia. First Secretary General was Trygve Lie. He was from Norway. But Yu Thant was the first Secretary General of United Nations from Asia. Then obviously, if you look at statement number 3, because Asia is not given, obviously 3 should be wrong. So now what should be done? If you can look at the alternates now, A, B, C, D, you have 3, statement number 3 in B, C and D. Since you know number 3 is wrong, wherever 3 is there, that should not be the answers. That should not be the answer. So obviously without reading statement number 4, you can come to a conclusion that the answer is A. Am I clear? Very, 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 very important. Fine. And for our information, please read the 4th statement. Single person cannot be the Secretary General for more than 2 terms is wrong. Let me tell you this point. There were incidents where one person was the Secretary General for 2 terms. Example, Ban Ki-moon itself. But the Charter of United Nations, it never and nowhere said that single person cannot be the Secretary General for more than 2 terms. He can be picked up even for the 3rd term, 4th term also. Is that okay? So obviously the 4th statement is also wrong. Am I clear? But kindly remember, so far no one has been picked up for Secretary General for more than 2 terms. So obviously what should be the answer? A should be the answer. Look at this. Yu Thant was the first Secretary General from Asia. But the first Secretary General of United Nations was Trygve Lie, and he was from Norway. Is that okay? Look at this. The criticism is that the Secretary General is elected in a selective process orchestrated by PFIR. Meaning ultimately what is happening is that who should be the Secretary General will be decided by the P5, permanent 5. Is it okay? Look at this next point. So far, no woman member was the Secretary General. And right now, the candidates so far in the race include 5 women. So many men are there, but out of these 5 women, so these are the important people. She is the Director General for this UNESCO. She is from Bulgaria, Irina Bokova. And second person is Helen Clark. She is the former Prime Minister of New Zealand. And third one is the Natalia Greman. She is the former Deputy Prime Minister of Moldova. And Foreign Minister of Argentina, Susana Malcora. And Foreign Minister of Croatia, that is Vesna Pusic. So these are all the important people who are there in the race so to become the Secretary General. So we need to wait and watch what is going to happen. What India thinks. So when it comes to what India thinks, India always thinks positively. India thinks that Secretary General should be such a person where the intentions of India should be fulfilled. But in reality, what happens is that intentions in the sense India wants to become the permanent member of Security Council like that. But whatever may India think, when it comes to the so-called Secretary General, the decision-making powers are again too less. But because the reason is simple, because it is dominated by the permanent 5. Is it okay? But India wishes to have a person so who can be looking after the peace and security of the whole world. Fine, India is positive, and hopefully India should strive its efforts, continue its efforts to become the permanent member of Security Council. Hope that day will come very, very soon. And that's all for today. And I'll stop at this stage, and I'll see you in the next class with some other topics. Thank you so much for being with me this evening. Have a wonderful evening. Good night.